Hi, welcome to A Word with the Desert Fathers and Mothers. I'm your host, Dr. Higgins, and in this episode, we'll be talking to Desert Mother Amma Sarah. Amma Sarah grew up in a Catholic household in the 5th century and was well educated throughout her childhood. Thank you for joining us today, Sarah.
Thank you for having me, Doctor. I'm happy to be here today talking with you.
Here we have the Amma of Siete, who lived in a cell of stillness near a women's monastic community for 60 years on the Nile River. So, Amma Sarah, you are known for saying, "According to nature, I am a woman, but not according to my thoughts." Can you elaborate more on what message you're trying to get across here?
Yes, of course. During the 60 years I spent as a hermit in Egypt, there were several occasions where I was challenged by the men passing by. While I was living in the desert in Egypt, I was visited by male anchorites who sought to embarrass me by telling me not to become conceited because men were visiting me. And when I said I was only a woman by nature and not by my thoughts, I meant that I will not waste my time worrying about if men approve or disapprove of my actions, because I will then find myself becoming a prisoner to what they want. Instead, I will pray to God to give me the strength that my heart and intentions will be pure towards all and free of judgment.
Wow, thanks for sharing your feelings during that time. I'd like to know more about your time of isolation on the Nile and more of what you learned about your relationship with God during this experience.
For 13 years in the Nile, I was tempted by a persistent demon of fornication. It was during this time in my life that I relied on God to give me the strength to wage this war against the vanities of the world. I gave myself up to the fear of God and to asceticism and often prayed to him in my terrace. Then the spirit of fornication appeared to me once and said, "Sarah, you have overcome me." And I responded, "It is not I who have overcome you, but my master, Christ."
And that's so inspiring and seems like it took a lot of strength, especially being tempted for that long. I heard you spent much of your ascetic life towards performing works of charity. What did you learn about how it pleases God?
I learned a lot from the women I spent time with in Egypt. They taught me the importance of performing works of charity. Even if our charity starts with the intention to please men, there will afterwards come that moment when it will become true charity because it pleases God. Many of the monks I lived with in the desert lived proper, respectful lives like I did. Often, I recognized in them the charity and hospitality that should exist within the hearts of all monks.
Great. It's good to hear you please God through those challenges you overcame and experienced the benefits of leading a monastic life. And that's it for today. Thank you to our guest, Amma Sarah, for joining us on A Word from the Desert Mothers and Fathers.
Of course. Thank you again, Dr. Higgins. I appreciate your time.
Thanks for listening, everyone, and make sure to tune in next week.